Yo, 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 what's up, everybody? Thank you for tuning in to today's podcast. It's Cody, Gotham's Caped Crusader. We're keeping it geekly. Yes, this is your number one stop for all things geek culture, from comic books to video games and so much more. And man, am I excited, because not only do we have some rather interesting pieces of news to discuss, with it being new comic book day, be sure to leave a comment down below letting me know which one is your favorite. With that being said, guys, let's go ahead and just dive right into that geek culture and see what's buzzing. Now, first thing circulating in the rumor mill, of course, is Barry Keoghan playing the Joker in the Batman universe. Now, Barry had a rather insane performance in Marvel's Eternals, and it looks like he is jumping ship to the DC side of things, where he's going to be playing as Commissioner Gordon's first partner, Stanley Merkel. Now, Dex Moy, who's had some rather insanely on the point leaks, has let us know that Barry could be starring as the Joker in Robert Pattinson's The Batman. Now, take it with a grain of salt, because this, of course, could prove to be false, but Barry's a pretty outstanding actor, so I am rather excited to see what will happen. On to the next piece of news, though. It looks like Insomniac's Wolverine is going to feature cuts, gouges, and much more. So according to recent hiring notices from the developers, this game could have a considerable amount of graphic content. Now, going verbatim off of this article, it looks like Drew Morey, Insomniac's principal designer, has recently shared a job posting from Sean McCable, Insomniac's head of technology, about a gameplay programmer role at Insomniac. Murray chimes in that the degree of brutality in Marvel's Wolverine, when he states that the respective programmer will be responsible for cuts, slashes, gouges, severs, gashes, stabs, sminks, and everything else that goes in moving and playing as Logan. Now, a lot of people are speculating that this is inferring to them being able to execute enemies with dismemberments and other gory attack animations in Marvel's Wolverine. Now, other than that job listing, not else is known about Marvel's Wolverine, but we will be sure to stay on the topic, because this looks like a game that I am going to love to play. Now, on to our next piece of news. It looks like Bandai Namco is about to pull Jump Force from its digital stores. Now, it looks like February 7th, 2022 is going to be the final day in which Bandai Namco is pulling Jump Force from its digital stores and shutting down servers completely. Now, in an announcement that was dropped just last Wednesday, the publisher also warned that these online services will cease to exist August 24th, 2022. Now, it looks like this is going to affect not only the Nintendo Switch, but the Windows PC, PlayStation 4, and the Xbox One. Now, it's always a shame when a game shuts its doors and closes down the servers, and with a lot of mixed reception, I am curious. Let me know in the comments down below what your thoughts are, and if you enjoyed this game at all. Now, with that being said, that does wrap up this week in Geek, but stay tuned. We got those fresh posts coming right out the oven. Now, the first issue that we're going to be covering this week is going to be Fear State I Am Batman, issue number 3, written by John Ridley, with art being done by Steven Segovo and Christian Deuce. Now, we begin this issue with a flashback on how Jace was able to deal with pain and absorb the hurt. And then we fast forward to him getting berated and belittled by his father, which is the worst pain of all. Effectively, Lucius thinks Jace is backsliding in the company, and he doesn't know that Jace has adapted their technology and becomes Batman by night. Now, meanwhile, Tanya, his mother, has taken on pro bono lawyer work with Morris, trying to understand who set him up for this. But it's not long before the Sears Moral Authority Army has taken and surrounded the juvenile detention center, and all hell is breaking loose. As bullets begin to fly and they bust out the big guns, we see Batman hit the battlefield. But little does Jace know that Simon Stain and Victor have a trick up their sleeve, and this might not go as planned for Jace. Now, I cannot wait for issue number 4 to arrive to see what happens to Jace and ultimately his mother as they are surrounded by the Moral Authority Army. Now, with that being said, this does lead us to Titans United, issue number 3, written by Kevin Scott, with art being done by Jose Lewis. Now, we find Connor Kent on the dark side of the moon as he is tied and bound by Blackfire, and she is asking some rather interesting questions, ending this panel with a forced kiss. Now, we pivot to Manside Private Airfield, California, as Lady Vic is getting ready to board a jet, but she is stopped by none other than Donna Troy, Red Hood, and Raven. Now, as all-out warfare is breaking loose between these two, we see Lady Vic sick her guards on them, but little do they know that these are Rosenbeck's experiments and things are about to get a lot more chaotic. Connor, on the other hand, is getting examined by Blackfire, and she sicks her metal lion, Pazil, on him, giving him the order to tear Connor piece by piece. Now, Lady Vic is able to escape on her jet, but Red Hood zip ties himself to the end. He's not letting her get away, and he is going to fight for his dear life in order to bring her back down. Now, this is going to lead us to our last book of the week, which is going to be Batman the Imposter, Book 2, written by Madison Tomlin, with art being done by Andrea Sorrentino. We begin with Leslie Tompkins wondering if she made the right choice, followed up with a flashback to Bruce Wayne's upbringing. Now, we see Alfred Pennyworth at his wit's end, wondering what to do with Bruce and suggesting that she drugs him. And at this point, she declines, and we see Alfred not only quit the role as butler, but send Bruce off to a military school in Russia. Now, Dawn's passed, and there's no sign of Bruce until we see him in the shadows, bloody, tattered, and torn. And thus, he gives us the story of how the night went sour for him. He was effectively trying to hack Wesker's network to get eyes on Gotham to find the imposter, but things, of course, did not go as planned. We also find out that Blair Wong is on the case, and she's connecting and putting all these dots together to find out who is funding the Batman, and all eyes are pointing to Bruce Wayne, and things aren't looking too good with him being one of the suspects, of course. Now, Bruce Wayne is facing a ticking time bomb as more and more bodies are piling, and he really has no idea how he's going to find this imposter. Now, with that being said, that does wrap up today's podcast, but you can always catch me on my respective social media platforms at Twitch, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, and so much more at JobForCody. And as always, guys, if you like this type of content, be sure to hit that big red subscription button, turn on notifications, and most importantly, leave a comment down below letting me know your favorite book of the week. As always, guys, keep it geekly.